Otherwise, I feel I have a weird floating bottom, and I don't like a weird floating bottom. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. Today, I am playing with the latest collection from Unique Beauty, the Fashion Magazine Africa edition. Yes, I am so excited for this. I'm technically still in my vacation, but I really, really wanted to film with this. I also did my nails. They are amazeballs. So yeah, if you are new though, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45. Am I 45? Yes. From the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you want to learn how to be fabulous in your 40s, if you just want to have fun with makeup again, if you want to see some unusual color combinations and just want to be inspired, then this is definitely the channel for you, because I am glorious and funny as hell. Hit the subscribe button, become part of my nestlings, because we are the bestest. We are the bombdiggity.com, the bee's knees of the internet. Yes. Now, how is this video built up? In this video, I will show you a look with all three palettes, so you get three looks in total, and I will also per palette give you my thoughts on it, and at the end of the video I will give you my overall thoughts. Now, I have been playing with Unique Beauty for quite some time. As I said, this is the third collection that I have from her, and I will list my Unique Beauty playlist down below, so I know what to expect from her eyeshadows, if that makes any sense. This is Fashion Magazine number four. This is the Africa inspired fashion edit, and it contains basically a book form outer palette with three palettes inside. All the palettes are cruelty free, and Unique Beauty is a UK based indie brand. I have an affiliate code if you want to use it to save some money. And yeah, in the collection, besides the three eyeshadow palettes, is blushes. And I received a blush, shade name is called Danakil. So this is the blush. It's a very, very pretty corally blush. And I will be using the blush and the highlighter throughout the entire video. The highlighter shade that she sent me is the shade Mavu. And it's perfect for me because I don't really like an icy highlighter on me. I can pull it off, I just don't like it. And especially in combination with the blush, it's very, very pretty. So those two I will be using. She also sent me a brush that I'm also using. It's the brushes that I love to use, these flame top brushes. And it's very, very soft. It's very, very nice. Without blabbering on too much, because I have been blabbering for quite some time now already, I'm going to prime my eyes with the Crow and Pebble eye base. That's I'm kind of trying that one out. I do like it. So yeah, it's a very, very cool toned one. So that is why I'm using it today, because I'm going to wear with. Oh yes, and my nails. Yeah, I did acrylic for the first time. It took me an entire day, but that was because I got fancy with the flowery stuff and such. So, eyes are primed and ready to go. So, the first palette that I am going to play with is called Roots, and it is six eyeshadows. This is just such a unique color story. I am, however, going to work with this differently though, because you see the very, very sparkly shades. They are flakes. I'm going to use those wet. I usually don't do that, but I am. I have also kind of thought about how I want to build up my look. I'm going to start with grabbing my color switch. I'm going to start with the yellow called Kente. Now, I don't know how to pronounce the names. I will do my best. I will do my absolute best, as I always do. So I'm going to start with the shade called Kente, which is the yellow. And when I look at it, it almost seems to have micro sparkle in it. It feels very soft when I swatch it as well, as does the gray. The black feels pretty dry, but that is not weird. So, nice. Also, this is a black woman owned indie brand. So the shadows are made for a darker skin tone. Next, I'm going to go to the shade called Yocolo, the gray. Now, this goes on like a dream. Blends out very, very well, which I was expecting. I'm cleaning my brush on a color switch, and then I'm going to blend the edges a little bit more. I do feel that this gray is a shade that you can blend away easily just because it is so soft. Which is both a good thing and a maybe not so good thing. It depends on how you do your eyeshadow, I think. Okay, then I'm going to go to the black. And apparently I'm switching to a very fluffy brush. The black is called Ochis. I'm butchering it so much. Okay, so this is a drier black. That means that I want to use it with a fluffy brush and on top of something. That's just how I want to use it. I do see that it wants to stick where I place it, which is good. But again, that's the reason that I'm using a fluffy brush, because I don't want to pack on the black. It's not how I use a black. But if you want to, you can. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the darkest blue first. I'm not going to use a glitter primer, because if I use a glitter primer, eyeshadows will crease. So I'm not going to do that. I am, however, going to spray against any fallout. So the plan is I'm going to start with Aso OK in the outer corner there. This glorious one on the lid, bluey purple. And I think I'm going to do this one in the inner corner and maybe on my bottom lid. I really want to do the yellow on my lid, but I also want to use the other shades. So the shade that's kind of throwing me off is the blue. Oh, maybe I can do the blue underneath my eye. Let's do that. Let's do that. I'm still having a cold. Can you tell? So this is a very, very sticky blue. So I'm going to tap off. I don't know how much you can see, but I'm really going to hang forward and hope that I get the minimum amount of fallout on my eye. So I'm going to do that here in the outer corner. Fallout isn't that bad, so that's good. Okay, I also wanted a little bit more on my upper lid just to connect. Otherwise I feel I have a weird floating bottom, and I don't like a weird floating bottom. Then I'm going to go back to a blending brush and I'm just going to kind of fade the edge a little, like so. Yes, okay. Now I'm going to do something I usually don't do, and that is going into a shade with a wet brush. And the reason that I'm going into the shade with a wet brush is because I hope that if I do that, I don't have a fallouty face. So I'm going to go to this shade first. I'm going to spray my brush and then I'm going to pick up the eyeshadow. And honestly, I usually don't do that, but we're going to do it today. Because this, I'm going to treat this as if it is loose. Okay, so I have picked up some. Tap of the brush, I'm probably going to create fallout anyway. I'm going to see if I need to spray again. Oh, this is very pretty. You can spray your brush again then if you want to. Maybe I will try that. And just take your time. If I hadn't done my face, I would have been a bit more bold. But yeah, I have done my face, so yeah. So now I'm actually going to spray my brush again after I have picked up some shade to see what happens. Okay, it helps. It just helps it to stick a little bit better. I do have fallout though. I don't know if I can get rid of it. We will see. Then I'm going to go to the yellowy shade and I'm going to do the same thing. It looks like this shade is even a little bit more, I don't know, flaky or maybe loose than the blue one is. But oh my lord. I want that here as well, but now I am going to use a glitter primer. And because I use the glitter primer now, I don't have to spray my brush, but I am kind of creating fallout. I want it more on top of that dark blue as well. Oh, it's going to be a mess to clean up, but it's so pretty. I'm going to be fabulously glorious, as always. Okay, then I'm going to go to the yellow. I'm tapping over the blue just in the inner part. I will kind of see if I can mix it a little bit in a minute. I don't have as much fallout as I expected, actually. Which is good. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to finish everything off.
Yeah.
look number two, and I have already primed my eyes with the Natasha Denona eye base, because this is a warmer toned one, and the shadows I'm going to use today are warmer toned as well, and I want to give them as much, I don't know, oomph as possible. So palette number two is called the Tribes palette, and it is, as the previous one, 6 shades. However, this is a warmer toned one. The darkest shade is Shimmer. I usually prefer the darkest one to be a matte. However, if it is a shimmer and then this type of shimmer, I don't really mind it that much. I am very, very interested on how it will perform, and I have an idea on what I want to do. Let's start with... Let's go a little bit differently today, because I can. Let's start the other way around. So, darkest to lightest, because I usually don't do that. I'm going to start with the shade Masai. I'm just going to tap it on. And then I'm going to lightly blend the edge a little. I'm going to go to a smaller brush. And then I'm going to grab the shade Ashanti. I'm going to blend out the previous shade with this shade. And then with another small brush, I'm going to go to the shade Ancestors, which is the yellow. Just placing it in the inner eye part area. It's time for the shimmers. I am going to start with the shade called Tribe. I'm going to use a dry in the outer corner. And when I'm looking forward, I'm going to fade it into the crease as well. I'm just going to pull it in, and it lends itself beautifully, and I have not grabbed anything extra, and I want that sharp line. And I'm just making sure that it is sharp. So basically, instead of a wing with eyeliner, I'm doing it with this eyeshadow. Okay, the next shade is going to be the shade Zulu. I'm going to spray it. Because I want to be able to create a sharper line. I'm tapping it on, and I want to keep it below the darker line. Then I'm going to go back to the previous brush. I'm going to grab my glitter primer. Then I'm going to go to the shade Himba. I'm also going to go back to the shade Tribe, that brown. Yes, I want to bring back what I have up top. So the eye pencil is going to be the LA Girl Shockwave Neon Liner in Outrage. This is it so far. I'm going to finish everything off, and then I will be back to show you the completed look and give you my opinion on this palette. I finished off the look with falsies from AOA Studio in the style Jean. The lippy I ended up picking is the shade Limitless from Propa Beauty, which is very much the shade I have in the crease, or at least above the crease, and then a fancy dress top thingamajiggy. I like it. I like how it turned out a lot. Let me give you my thoughts on this palette. This is basically almost a warmer neutral palette. The mattes are very easy to work with. The yellow, I feel, does need a certain amount of stickiness to really pop. That is the nature of a lot of yellows, but especially with this yellow, and I think that's more along the lines of the tone than the quality. It's just that the tone is almost more geared towards a skin tone than it is a very popping... Yeah, does that make any sense at all? I don't know. I think this palette will complement a lot of skin tones though. And I like it. I like how the look turned out. So for my personal collection, this is not really a unique color story. It is, from what I have from her, unique though. And I do think that it complements this theme that she has going on very, very well. Yes, that was it for Pallet number two, the tribes. So if you need a refill, grab it now. Otherwise, just relax and enjoy, because here comes pallet number three. The last look and the last pallet. And the last pallet is, I think it's called the African Queen palette. That's at least how I describe it. And it's the same format as the others. This is just a little bit more. Is it on the berry side? I actually have no idea. It is another pretty neutral color story, but more along the lines of the cool tone neutral. And I think that the shade Moremi really gives the palette something extra. I have primed today with the Anastasia Beverly Hills eye primer, because it's a very it's a cool toned primer. That's why I want it. And I actually want to go the same route that I did yesterday. So I want to start with the darkest shade, just because I want to, I don't know, teach myself how to do my makeup like that, because I can. I'm going to start with a shade called Nandi. And I'm following my bottom lid up. And then in, so I know where I need to stop. Next, I'm going to go to the shade called Cleopatra. It's going to go more in. I'm going to blend the edge. And I'm going to use this shade to blend the edge of the previous shade as well. Then, with a very fluffy brush, I'm going to go to the shade Sheba. I'm just going to blend out everything. So this is how I love to use a shade like this, as an eraser or a blender. But I also love to use this, for instance, clean up the lid now and then put it on the lid to just do an all matte look. It will be very, very pretty as well. Especially if you're darker. Then I love looks like that. Okay. I'm going to go back to the first shade. Just re-intensify it a little. Blend it a little bit more into the crease. Let's, for funsies, grab the shade Sheba, which is that very, very pale shade. And just use it to lighten up the inner eye part area. Very subtly, but that is okay, okay. I am going to go to the shimmers, which are not... It's not going to be very, very complicated. Let's start with a shade called Ya, which is going to go outer corner and a little bit on the lid, I think. I'm going to use it dry first, so I'm going to tap off. I'm not going to use it in the outer corner, I actually have decided. Ooh, very pretty. I am going to fade it onto the darker shade. Yes, and I also want this underneath my eye. This all over the lid will be stunning, but that's not what I want to do. I am going to go to the shade called Moremi. I'm going to spray it, and that's going to go on the rest of my lid. Yes, I'm also going to pull it on top here. Oh, this just gives it a whole other dimension. I actually grabbed a lip brush, because I want a very small brush for here. To give it a little bit of extra interest sparkle. So I'm brushing it over kind of dry-ish, which kind of means that I create a little bit of fallout, but who cares, right? If you do care, do your eyes first if you're going to do something like this. Okay, inner corner is going to be the shade Nefertiti. This is dry. Ooh, that's nice. We'll also make a gorgeous highlighter. I'm brushing it up a little bit. I usually do that with a light shimmer shade. Because my eyes are a little bit deep set, I kind of open them up a bit. Nice. This is it so far. I'm going to finish everything off, then I will be back to show you the final look and give you my opinion on this palette and the entire collection. I finished off the look with my favorite falsies from Primark, the baby dolls in style 723. Lippy is a combination from a Catrice Plumping Lip Liner in the shade Star and Roll, and one of the Kaleidos Lip Clays in the shade Dune, which is from their Sandcastle set. Yes, the eye pencil, I ended up picking a yellow one from Root Cosmetics. It's one of their Flashing Lights, City of Flashing Lights pencils in Always On. Because I kind of needed to tie it together a little bit with my outfit, because I'm having a mood. Let me zoom out so you can see the mood. This is the mood. I also have a very nice pencil skirt underneath, and my, I think it's going to be glorious weather today, but this is my mood. So yeah, let me give you my opinion on this palette. I like the color story of this. It's not a color story that I have a lot of, because it's usually not a color story that I go for. Honestly, what makes this one so fun and unique is the shade Moremi, which I have all over the lid. It just gives it a whole other vibe. Now, I do like the color story that is in here, and it is more basically colorful than I thought it would be at first glance. It's a cooler toned, warm tone. When I look at this, I'm like, it's a cool tone palette. But then when I look closer, I can see that it is a warm tone as well, but still on the cooler side of that warmer. Does that make sense at all? I hope so. Quality wise, no issues whatsoever. The mattes layered, the mattes blended. The shimmers are very, very pretty. But yeah, the star of the roll for me is the shimmer that I have on my lid. Do I think the palettes are worth it individually? Quality wise, yes, I do. I believe they retail for, I think it's actually $15.50 per palette. And then the complete bundle is, if I'm not mistaken, $52. I can be mistaken because I failed to look it up, as per usual. Yeah, this is a collection that, for what she has, it is the most neutral one, with the exception of the first palette. Yeah, I think that's it. And I do think that that is, do I want to say, was it missing in her collection? Not necessarily for me, but I love color. But I know that a lot of you are maybe struggling a little bit with color, and then this can be the perfect collection for you to try out Unique Beauty, because there are two palettes in here that are pretty neutral for most people. And then there's that Roots palette, the first palette that I played with, which is basically, yeah, the showstopper of this collection, honestly. This is the moneymaker of the collection for most people, I think, because it's just such a unique combination between the yellow and the blue. This is just not something that you see a lot in a palette. Out of all the palettes, which one is my favorite? I actually think that it is the Roots palette, so the first palette, just because of the uniqueness of the color story. It inspires me a lot. For me, an everyday palette, I think, could be more along the lines of this one. If you find that you are, or you know that you are, on the more delicate spectrum of the color story family, basically that means that some more toned down and muted colors look better on you than very vibrant and primary colors, then this collection is definitely for you. If you love vibrant colors, maybe this is too toned down for you. I don't feel like one palette is better quality than the other. There are different finishes in all the palettes, so I think that is a preference, and I think it's just a color story preference. Let me also talk to you about the blush and the highlighter that I have been using throughout the entire video. Yeah, they are very, very pretty. The highlighter is a highlighter that you can pick up a lot if you want to. You can make it very, very blinding. You can make it a little bit more toned down. I feel like it is very, very flattering on me, and I love a smooth formula like this. Then the blush, yeah, I love this blush. The fun fact about this blush is it looks very vibrant and almost too vibrant for me when I look at it, but when I hold it next to my face, I can see that it is a little bit more muted as well. So it's still a vibrant color, but it's also a little bit more muted. When I put it on, it's very, very pretty. So on an olive complexion, again, this is a very, very pretty shade. You can build it up, you can sheer it out, you can blend it out very, very well. It layers beautifully on top of a cream blush. Definitely worth it, in my opinion. That is it for me today. Let me know down below if you have any of these. I will leave where you can find it down below. I also have an affiliate code with the brand and that I will leave down below as well. That will save you 10%. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.